It's been a bit. I'm still adjusting to Walgreens. I actually got promoted to a shift lead and still figuring out the schedule. Sorry about that. Today we are drawing Allie from A Star Is Born, played by Lady Gaga. A shot from the end of the movie. So let's get to it. I threw on Electra in the background. Almost hit the tab button. We don't want to do that. So we're going to start by drawing the shape of the face, which is typically... Hang on. We want a little bit looser, so we're going to up the size of the brush. Put the texture back on. Sorry, I don't know if you guys can see all that. But again, sorry, we're doing a close-up of the face, so her face isn't exactly like straight on. It looks like it's the tiniest bit tilted, but we'll try to get into that a little later. Anyways, again, I try to do a circle. Bottom of the circle should be where the nose might be. I say might because stuff changes. I like to keep it loose in the beginning. And then add our details, we can continue on. So you can tell this is already a little weird. Actually, I have an idea. Let's control Z all of this. And then let's draw the base head. We go like that. Let's just freehand it. That would be eye line, nose line, mouth line, and then the chin would be right there. But we're going to control T this. We're going to grab it, make it bigger. I think I have free transform on, so when I hit control T, I can like do all that. You don't want to do that though. So in order to, if you have that on, just hold shift down and you should be able to like move it on the different axes. And if you go to scale it, it won't like mess with the perspective or distortion. But it looks like her eyes are really the focus of this. Yeah, it's a little bigger. Okay, do that. I'm just trying to get the general shape down right now. Let me type in the chat. Sorry if you guys can hear all that. Should have had that typed already. That's okay. Live and we learn. Let me actually post this to somewhere else. Sorry, get back to it. Drawing her jawline. I guess her eyes are up here. Isn't Lady Gaga's real name like Stephanie? I had a good friend who is obsessed with Lady Gaga. I don't know if he still is. He was a big, big fan. I wonder how he liked this movie. Because it was really... I can't... if he enjoyed all of the like eccentricness that she has with her, like as a person, like in the costumes that she wears and the music she makes. I don't know if he like, if I'm remembering right, I think he liked like her, I guess, normal self too. Well, not normal, but maybe the more private side of her. This is looking real rough, but that's okay. We trust the process. Why did I draw her mouth all the way down there? It's supposed to be like right here. Lovely, lovely. I think we're gonna have to cut down some of her. Oh, not that. That was weird. It's a little bit of her forehead because we can't see that high. Of course, her eyes are on the third. I don't know why I didn't think of that. Wish I could. Can't forget the microphone that's right here. Really liking it so far. Oh, I just did Control Shift. I did Control Shift N. I should be using my brother's phone holder. He has a. So as to not affect the pressure that I'm applying to the screen. I made the brush a little bigger to cover more ground because I know I'm going to go over a second pass with a shadow. Typically I like to do that like after I've gone in darker, but the image is pretty contrasty, so contrasty? I don't know the phrase for that. High contrast. There's a bit right there. Under the nose is pretty smart. In the storyboarding book that I've been reading, it talks about the rendering process. And rendering, if you don't know, is just the process of making something look good. I don't know how. I mean, I know that like in CG and stuff, rendering is like when you're, I guess, exporting the files. I'm not too sure. Processing everything. As it relates to storyboarding, it's more like polishing the storyboard to make sure that it looks pretty, which is not at all mandatory. But it is practice when showing to executives or when sequences require higher amounts of detail to communicate more information. So think of like a really difficult action sequence where there's a lot of stunts or even explosives, where everybody needs to be prepped on what is going to happen. And sometimes it gets to be easier to communicate that visually instead of, like, say, in a production meeting or something. I was really catching the light over there. Hello. I don't know who the second viewer is, but howdy. Now, this is kind of an interesting stage in the process. Well, I guess I could go in and just try and do more detail. That actually makes more sense. It's lesson. Let me keep that up a little bit. 83, 58. No, let's listen to more. Alright, we're going to do another layer with some more detail. It's going to be... oops. Charcoal pencil. We're going to go in with another layer and try to put a bit more refinement around the details of her face so that it actually looks like Lady Gaga. Not that this doesn't, but we want it to look more like her. Going for some realistic stuff. And that is typically done in the eyes. I think there's a Scarface scene that I've seen on social media. Where it's like, it's in the eyes, Chico, or something like that. Oh, wrong layer. Close. Control shift N. There we go. Now, I am slightly concerned about making this look pretty, but I know I'm going to go over it later, so it doesn't have to be perfect. I just really want to communicate that this is Lady Gaga. Super bass speakers. I forget about Elektra, both the superhero and the like as a movie. Jennifer Garner was out here doing the female-led superhero thing. Wish I could. Oh, skip survey. I think last time I streamed, I put on Hot Rod. interesting thing to watch while you're doing Daniel Day-Lewis from There Will Be Blood. I thought about putting A Star Is Born, but I didn't feel like getting into my feels. The movie breaks my heart. Okay, those lines are a little confusing, but they're just different, I guess, concentrations of value. There's a gray and there's a much darker shadow. I thought about using the symmetry tool, but I think real faces, most of them at least, are very asymmetrical. Even though from a distance, most faces, I mean, like, I guess traditionally people that look good have just symmetrical faces. When you get up close to someone, you can see all the imperfections. Like someone's eye. I know one of my eyes is a little higher. There's a lot of asymmetry in my own face. Sometimes I wonder if I reflect that in my drawings by refusing to make someone look perfectly symmetrical. Just food for thought. We'll see if we have to move this down, but yeah, I can tell we already do. Let's grab Control T, let's move down a little. That looks like it works a little better. Control D. Nose is supposed to be like up here. That's where we're gonna be some highlight. So her eye would be even closer. It's all good. It's all good. That's why we do this. I apologize if you can't hear me. You should be able to hear me. Yeah. I don't apologize. Control D. I used the lasso tool to select something and grab it, and then I didn't know for a while, but you can hit Control D to deselect something. Otherwise, you'll only, like, your brush will only affect what's selected, and you that can be an advantage. Like, if you're trying to color something really quickly, you don't want to change the blending option of the layer, you can use the lasso tool to grab and do that. But I didn't know that. So sometimes I would, like let's say, for right now, I'm going to grab her eye. See, I select it, I'm moving around, and then it's identified the brush strokes. I would move this around, hit enter, but now the thing's still there. And to get rid of this, I would go outside, grab something that's not on my canvas, and go back to it. But you can just hit Control D and it'll do the same thing. Thank you. I wonder if I'll understand this movie more if I actually watch it. I'm real confused right now what's going on. I know that the girl that this was following just came in. I remember my brother hasn't seen A Star Is Born. I'm trying to get him to, but he hasn't seen it, and for anyone that has seen it knows that Bradley Cooper plays a character. And there's Grammys. There's a Grammy scene, and I told my brother that at the most recent Grammys, Bradley Cooper got so drunk and he pissed himself. And I showed him the scene, and he thought it was real for a sec. It was pretty funny. Got him. Oh, that's what that is. When I was walking out, I noticed that there was like a sharp triangle of color. It's just her neck muscles. Got some hair with it that's a little reminiscent of the Joker. Let's bring her thing down a little bit more. It's a little bit closer to where it is. Yeah, there we go. Wanted to get some of that look, that tilt. Not bad. Alright, we're gonna add a temp layer in the background. It'll be just a dark gray, just so I can start to add value to her. Oof. There we go. It's a little better. So we're gonna do this similar to the John Wick, where we use the hard round pressure opacity brush to add hues of color. Yeah, but she's not nearly as lit, moodly lit. John was bathed in blue and pink or red, so, but she's like being lit straight on and kind of, I think, from the top left. Rembrandt, I believe that's the style. Do a basic wash all the way through on the parts that I know are like lit well. And I mentioned Rembrandt earlier, but I watched a brief video that talked about Rembrandt. I think it's Rembrandt. If it's the wrong name, I do apologize. But it's like this lighting that creates a triangle on one half of the face. It's like up and a bit in front of the subject. It's supposed to be one of the most appealing lighting setups used by artists, because it really, like, you get a good sense of the face, but you can also like have nice shadows that are just enough to show the shape of something. What's up, man? I hope everything's okay. I didn't see that my connection is pretty bad, or I hope it's not bad, but I hope it's better now. But hey, man, I have to have been drawing for, is it only 30 minutes? Oops, that's the wrong one. Yeah, only 30 minutes, cool. How you been, Jesus? Good, that's good to hear. With all this in shadow. Shadow in quotation marks, of course, nothing super heavy. What up, brother? Hope work's okay. Bet you must be chillin' right now, big chillin'. Don't worry, guys, it'll look better and better, I promise. Let's put some more red over here. We'll do the lips for now just to differentiate, and then probably I'm gonna have to go in with the pink. Looks like the Blades of Chaos to me. Oh, that was a good setup, everyone. Let's go in with an off grayish yellow for the eyes that we will touch up. Or that you never want to go too bright for the eyes because then it limits you later on. Like you can't add too much highlight if you use bright white. The reason you saw me do a second pass was just because I'm trying to create some sorts of lighting. Light's coming from her right, so the left sides of her pupil are darker, if that makes sense. Or Probably not. Let's go with the pink. It's time to implement some other brushes. You guys know I'm a fan of that oil texture. It's not bad. But we want a little bit more color. It's a little redder, so let's control Z that. Too white. Face cam watch. I was thinking if I should do a face cam. Gotta make sure my background's clean, you know what I'm saying? Wait, her nose. Why did I not do her nose? Wow, that's pretty genius. I don't know why I didn't think of that. There's so many honorary triplets, brother. In the best way, though. The more the merrier. Who are they? Jesus, I believe Abby's an honorary triplet. Is Dan Larson? Is the music? Yeah, the music's still going. Sorry. Have a good old time. Let's focus out here. I'm gonna go in with a pencil now. Let's make sure I'm, which one? Oil 6 under 2019. Instead. Hang on.
all computers now have primary control of critical vehicle functions.
It's really crazy what some whites can do. Damn, I didn't do that. That's okay. No, it's not okay. We're whining, just so you guys can see. Alright. I'm just going in with some highlights. Oh, look, her pupil's too big. Yeah, you guys can hear me. Kind of wild. Very, very cool. Might go with a charcoal pencil to do some more details. Just gorgeous. I don't know if that's gold, but we'll treat it like it's gold. I'm gonna have to probably blend the skin, but just want to get these highlights out because it just looks so cool. Let's do this. Whoops. Oh god. Okay. Her eye is a little bit closer. A viewfinder probably would have been really helpful to have. That's okay. That's why we do what we do. Jeez, why does her eye look so bad? That's okay, we're gonna keep working until we get this right. When I zoom in, it looks fine. Let's zoom in on the eye. When I zoom out, it's clearly going the wrong direction. Pulling out again. damn it, I misplaced my pen. Oh no, there it is. My pen, I definitely meant stylus. Thanks, Herman. How is work, brother? Please tell me that you got all of Papa John's tuning into the stream. I was just joking. That'd be pretty funny. That's okay, brother. I was just joshing. you. I need to make your lips look way less chapped. It's probably a lot smoother. So let's identify, not a neutral, but we kind of want something that can encompass a little bit more. I love it when some of the teeth get reflection too. Should I use a blender? We could try to see. I feel like I just need to add more tones to her. There you are. Let's see. Oh, it's a different layer. Duplicate this layer just to see. Whoa. That helped a ton. Maybe I don't need a blend. I'd say that was pretty cool, just how that happened. Then we'll go back to the pencil up here. Some more details, finish up probably. And then maybe we'll use a charcoal pencil. We'll go to 20, flip off that. No, the texture's off, cool. Let's go crazy with the hair. Not crazy, but like, you know, let's just do it up. Grab that deeper brown. Sorry. I'll do these edges hairs after. Your eyes should be bigger now. Let's see if I... Sorry. It looks like your eyes should be bigger, so let's see if we can't grab them. Thanks, man. Can you hear me? Yeah, you can hear me. Cool, cool, cool. Yeah, it looks way better. This is hot worry for a sec. For a good while, I was like, that looks nothing like her. Well, not a good while. I was like, I took a step back and I was like, wow, man, we could do better. And I'm glad we are. I have to do some glitter stuff over there, and then the microphone, and then I'll be able to call it, because I fixed the eyes. Thank goodness that was rough for a sec. Let's do these grays. guys have enjoyed. Sorry, I kind of fell silent there. I was just really focused. But thank you for coming.